very peculiar day. My mirror lured someone out of his bed and opened a doorway to my workshop. I do not know if the mirror was being mischievous or malicious. Perhaps it knew that the curious intruder had a role to play in my project. I was putting the finishing touches on my latest creation. A world for things that have been forgotten. Satisfied with my progress, I put the magic brush down and retired to my chambers. Had I known what events would follow, I would have locked away everything. Paint, brush, and thinner. And rushed to see what had happened. But I was too late. The world I had created was ravaged. A wasteland. The mysterious intruder was gone. I did not learn his identity. Well, not for a very long time.
Hello and welcome to Demo Play Thursday. Yeah, that all started before we got to this title screen here. So, Epic Mickey came out on the Wii, and it's one of those Wii games that I never played, even though I had a Wii. I just remember at the time the complaints about the controls, and I just feel like I didn't have enough interest in Disney to warrant putting myself through the controls. So here, as Rebrushed, I'm kind of interested not only how it looks in HD, but also how they work around the controls. Because I think like the sequel is like a co-op game as well, so Epic Mickey and Epic Mickey 2 are kind of two games I'm curious about, but not so much that I really wanted to play or put myself through whatever the issues were with them. So yeah, it's nice that this screen says it's a demo, but it was a bit of a shock going straight into the story. That's a cool story, though. I like how they got it to fit in with the general time scale. Ah, you see that? PlayStation Store. So we're able to pre-order, wish list the game from here, which is great, because if you play the demo and like it, it'd be great from the demo to pre-order or get the game. So that's a good thing to do. Let's have a look at settings, see how sensible they are. None of this makes any sense because we haven't played it. What's that? Is that brightness? Again, it doesn't make any sense because there's nothing there to show us what the changes are. Language, audio. So, click. All that space and there's like a click. Why can't we just like pick a flag or something? I don't know. Accessibility, what we got? Okay, so color blindness. Oh, I don't want to look at that. I still believe the demo should tell you either itself in gameplay or via in-game tutorials how and what buttons do what. So let's start. I don't know how long this demo is going to be. The point of demo play first day isn't necessarily to finish a demo, but to maybe play like an hour. So we'll either finish the demo or an hour gets played, whichever comes first. Talk about some mild peril to start the game with. Imagine this game isn't designed exactly for little kids, because it's a little scary, isn't it? Full on as well. And who's Gus? Obviously, I know who the other character is because I was around when this game first was revealed, so I know that's Oswald. GLaDOS here is it's having it all together. Escape. Okay, we can't seem to keep out of its vision. It's like, how are we meant to avoid all that? Square, okay. Okay, it's very much tell us what to do and how to do it. I can appreciate that. I'll tell you, you might be able to hear the PS4 in the background, because this is the PS4 version of the demo. It's really pushing it. Even though it's just a demo. Yeah, this HD revamp of the game looks pretty nice. Even the intro cinematics that we've seen so far, they look like being completely redone into, I suppose, 1080p? Excellent. The game is very much saying, hey, this is open, you can explore it, or here, we're finished, you can leave. I can appreciate that. It's not so much hand-holdy, it's giving us the choice. Some mobile games that we play on Mobile Friday are very hand-holdy. There you go, Lost World. But I can appreciate the game having this sort of approach. Picking up some sort of collectible. Okay, collectibles, okay. It says you should see how many you've collected. How? Where is that button? Ooh. Mad Doctor's Lab. Again, if we collect stuff, tell us how to view it. Well, you see, something's weird there, isn't it? Lots of destructible things. Huh, but not that. It's weird, Mickey's moving. You can see his legs, the little legs, are moving really quickly. And yet, we don't seem to be moving fast. It's like a lot of effort is going in for very little movement on screen. More Oswald stuff. Is, I know they showed an exit, but I can't tell you. I'm guessing it's that one up there. And I'm guessing where we went is the secret. But again, it's not explicit. It's not like an arrow is placed above it just to make sure that we know what we're doing and where we're going. So, Scar, Maleficent, I think that's Hook. Oh, nuts. We splattered and lost a heart. Okay. Ooh, what's behind this door? Can't go that way. With it being a demo, you're not 100% sure if that is because it's a demo and they're restricting where we can go, or if it is actually what it's like in the game. With this game not out yet, you have to wait and see, or you guys in the comments who might have played the original can offer up some information. Yeah, I nearly fell down there, didn't I? See, this isn't here yet either. Well, let's follow where it wants us to go. Let's leave. I know it's not the exit. I just saw a door and wanted to try it. Oh man, I took too big a jump, didn't I? Should have taken a narrow jump. Interesting. I bet that's going to be a story point at some point where are we the monster or not? L2's thinner, R2's paint. So we use thinner to erase it and paint to restore it. Okay. So we get that token and then restore it. Thankfully, it doesn't seem like there's a limit to how much ink we have. See, it's got some reach, doesn't it? Makes you wonder if there are benefits for erasing stuff like that. Can we erase every wall, or is it just going to be certain walls? It's like, it's not everything. Makes you wonder. I mean, I can understand why there are the limitations, but it kind of feels you should do all or nothing. You shouldn't have some aspects where you can do stuff and some where you can't. See? Why is some parts okay and some not? It's just there, cartoon aspects he said that we can do, but what makes this a cartoon and not this a cartoon? I like that idea. It doesn't look like we can fight that stuff. I don't even know what that green thing is that we're picking up. Now we've got some blue there, some green. What is all of it? Oh wait, you see on the left, bottom left, bottom right, it isn't infinity. Okay, so we do have an actual limit. So I wonder how we earn ink. I guess it is we just break stuff and we pick it up as we go. He doesn't seem like he likes us, does he? What a weird little creature. Makes you wonder what the benefit is of making them friends. Like, these are obviously shining, so they're obviously things we can hit. It makes you wonder if everything else that we can ink or thin is also going to be equally as obvious. See how these are shiny and the plant isn't? That's invisible, so ink it. What's here? I didn't even see one, the first one. Okay. I didn't make it a friend though, did it? So wow, we're thinning, but we're not making it our friend. I wonder what we can do to fix that. Or perhaps it's just the game's way of explaining that we're not killing them, we're just making them our friend. Perhaps that's what it's trying to tell us. Well, it certainly controls well. Of course I did that. I can't believe I just did that. Now bring them back. It's weird. You kind of would think that maybe by restoring everything, there'd be some sort of visual thing in the level that make that. I don't know. I'm just expecting that we do all this and we get something changed in the level. Where did they just appear from? So we do get points for exploring then. And we got a chest. Now, can we hit this with anything? Doesn't look like it. All these blue things. I just guess you smack it. He didn't say anything once we got there, did he? Well, the repairing was starting, then we'll do things. So I guess that's telling us what we need to do. Extra content towers. There's no context for what that means, is there? These green lights, you think they're just lighting the way for us so we know where to go and what to do? Oh, this. Okay, I shouldn't have gone there. Thankfully, we're just like losing a little bit of health. It's not huge problem. And then your health's back. So, not that, but the floor. Feels like it's a good tutorial area. We're doing all sorts of uses of the brush, but it feels like natural part of the level. I recognize that background. A part of me would like just to jump off, but I imagine that would do a lot of damage. And there's no like shortcut from here down. We're gonna have to go all the way back. I suppose we could jump, but why risk it? An L3 is run. And you don't need to hold L3, you can just press it once and you're running. Pretty much just like when it comes to debris and stuff like this, we're going to be manipulating stuff, puzzles and whatnot, moving the debris up and down, probably down, to navigate. We're in the air. Oh, like a butt stomp, okay. Not the kind of gremlin I'm familiar with. Huh. That's an interesting dilemma. Well, let's get this guy out first. See, so we could have gone bronze, so we could have got an item or a gold pin. It's one way of adding replayability. Make us play the game twice to get different outcomes. Paint is not working on that. There's the paint. Yeah, let's just go in. Are we just gonna watch a cartoon, or we're gonna do like a level set in that cartoon universe? That's how we're doing a side scroller. I don't have access to the ink brush. Okay, I mean, I don't have access to the inks to do anything with them. Like, there's no thinning, there's no colouring. Ah, come on. Yeah, the music, not exactly Disney-esque, is it? More height. I I can understand how we get these, the bomb ones here, but... okay, that might be what they want us to do. Kind of a bit surprised with Epic Mickey's moveset. We never saw them come into Smash Brothers. I wonder if there was some debate about Mickey losing. I mean, Disney weren't happy to see their main mascots lose. What we use these red tokens for? Okay, so trying to time the jump as soon as we hit the bed. Timing is surprisingly difficult. It makes me wonder if we're meant to actually do this. I guess we go on the tree on the left. There's a cloud on the right, but I don't think that's what we wanted to do. Can't get a double jump off the bed either. Get a double jump onto it. Like, that is your one jump. Hey, we made it. Now one of these clouds start to disappear on us. Oh, right, okay. Should we go in the projector or should we explore? Well, explore a little bit, but I think that's fine. Whoops. Haha. I wasn't paying attention to what I was doing on the controller, sorry about that. Let's try this again. Okay, we'll continue from here then. That's nice, isn't it? Okay. that's that done then. Secrets. Any secrets? So there's something around here. It's weird because it looked like the stage, didn't it, this area, rather than it being parts of level something that we can interact with. But yeah. Yeah, I guess it means we really do have to pay attention to what we're doing. Okay, it's that simple. It's weird how we have to do like one bit and two bits, then whole big bit. Was that a bit unnecessary, unneeded? Like, we can be fine without it. Imagine it's probably just a hangover from the Wii version. Ooh. That's not exactly Mickey's eyes, though, is it? We're right beside Mickey. How bizarre. Okay. Doesn't look like as much we can interact with. Like, if we are fixing the steam and the pipes, shouldn't we see like some pressure gauge go up? Damn it, fell through the only hole there was. Thankfully, we respawned really quick. That's nice to know. All right, let me double jump myself, but then you get a platform like that. It's not fully appeared. I was wondering if they were going to go through like the green stuff and we have to spray them. Whoa! Why is it so difficult to judge distance here? I wonder if it's because there's no shadow on Mickey whilst we're in the air that it's hard to judge distances. Something over there. Oh, well, whilst we're down here, might as well have a look. Whoa. That looks a little further than I thought it was going to be, so. That's an awkward camera angle, isn't it? And that's not going to help. See, from that angle, I can't see where the green is. So it's a little bit of a weird choice. Well, we can get ourselves back up on here, so. But yeah, I'm a little worried about the platforming, especially when in a dark area like this. You saw how the camera pulled itself up, so I wasn't even 100% clear where I was going to land just then. Why tease that if we can't get to it like that? Okay. I know we gotta worry about. See, he's fainting before I'm able to make him my friend. I get it. It isn't so much weaken with green, just throw lots of blue at them. I imagine they're going to be trophies for that, for how many of them you make your friend or not. So like if you get 100% friendship, maybe that's like a gold trophy, or maybe that changes the story. Yeah, I imagine that is some sort of story. Like, you get an ending, but maybe by making everyone your friend, you get a happy ending. Or you get a sad ending or a bad ending for not making everyone your friend. Again, it's another way of making us play through the game more than once. So a replayability, or a replay value, I should say. How did we get a guardian in the first place? So we got one guardian. Made our friend. Is he gonna join us and attack with us? I guess so. Yeah, the good guys help us. But then that guy is attacking everyone. See, any time, again, the game's encouraging us to explore. Interesting. So we can, yeah, on the top left, we've got, it's got a little bit more complicated. So that makes that. Okay, it looks like it's an and or. You either make it red or you make it green. You can't do both and expect. Yeah, it's like you can't keep changing and making it one colour than the other, one colour than the other. So try and get all the guardians. Like this. If I make that go away, it doesn't change the green. It only adds or detracts from the blue that was there. So we've got one guardian. It doesn't do anything, does it? So why is that square there? See, with this ability, we could go back to the previous level and rebuild some of the things there. I have to imagine that some of the Guardians work better in some situations than others. So we're working towards the Green Guardian. Well, I'd have a go at it, see what it looks like. Because look, you've got little tickets here to find. I'm sure these are useful somewhere. Ah, we've got two green guardians. So you can either have green or blue by the looks of it. These look all built. I don't know what we're expected to do here. Like, we can't fix it. We can fin it. I don't know, it's just, with it being Disney, I feel like if I'm going to fin everything, it's going to be a negative outcome for the world. You know, Disney is meant to be a happy, colourful place. If I'm removing all that colour, surely that's a bad ending. It's not going to go up, is it? Oh, it doesn't disappear. Well, it looks good. I just worry that this game is introducing many gameplay mechanics and ideas this early on without fully explaining the benefits or, you know, the good or the bad of it. It's like, why is this game suddenly more complicated than I feel like it needs to be? Again, the jump there. There is a shadow when you're close, but as soon as you get too far away, it kind of gets pretty hard to see. Almost as if Mickey needs a little bit of a lock on to kind of automatically jump to a platform. Doesn't feel like this is so much a puzzle section. It's like this is very much, well, this particular point is very much a ink these ones and thin these things and you're fine. I don't mind that, but it kind of hints as to some puzzle elements later. It's like we were told to thin that, I'm told to ink that. I have to imagine at some point there's going to be a combination of both thinning and inking to help do something. Yeah, you don't want to spoil, but in the comments, if you know, then yeah, please talk about it. Especially if you played the original, how different does this look, or how different does it play from what you've already seen or played before? I don't have the context of the Wii version to know, but that's it. Okay. No screenshots, no artwork, no trailer. Back to main menu, I guess. I'll just leave it to see if maybe there's a trailer. If you've been catching the PS3 live streams, especially the ones on Thursdays when we do demos, some of the games we played have had like a hidden trailer where you don't touch anything on the, like this screen, and it'll just play a trailer. Like I think Motorstorm did, I think Haze did. But we just did Uncharted, and it didn't. So I just leave it a little bit. But it's a good demo in that it there are lots of possibilities where this could go. The combat seems fine, but again, it feels like we're moving a lot. Well, it feels like Mickey's moving a lot, but we are not. And I know that's probably because Mickey's small, but it's just a little bit of a weird disconnect. It's not something I'm used to. I'm just a little concerned about the mechanics being a little much. And is there a point to inking and uninking? Is there like a good ending, a bad ending about all this? Again, it feels like as a Disney game, you want a happy ending, you want colour. Isn't that surely what we have to do? So it'd be nice if there was a menu somewhere saying that, hey, you've inked or restored or coloured in certain percent of the world. Because what's the point in thinning? Thinning's bad. Thinning hurts, destroys, removes. So, I don't know. After playing the demo, I don't think I want to really play it anymore. I just don't think the game's for me. I feel like I've got more questions than the game's going to answer. But it is a good demo. We do get a lot. We get a lot of characters, a lot of action, a lot of inking, a lot of tutorial stuff. So it is pretty good. But it looks like there's no trailer here either, so I think we can end it there. So until the next Demo Play Thursday video, or until I see you checking out some of the other videos, playlists, shorts, and now live streams we do, or maybe I'll see you over at Ko-fi. As a small YouTube channel, we get no money from YouTube. But with Ko-fi, we can get donations, including PayPal donations, and we've got a couple of subscription tiers. Until we get 500 subscribers, we can't earn any money from YouTube. So Ko-fi gives us a way to earn some money until we reach that landmark. But wherever, whenever I see you again, please, take care.